My name's Jason Mills. I've just returned from a year working in Turkey. I was responsible as head of mission for the Turkey programs and also our cross-border operations in northern Syria. We worked in Kobane in northeastern Aleppo province, and we're also beginning to work in Talabiyat in northern Iraq project. So I was very excited to go on this mission. I'd been following the news, the siege of Kobane, the near total destruction of this town, the lack of health care for the local population. MSF planned to go in and build a hospital with surgical and secondary care. At the time, the local military was doing surgeries in the basement of a school. As the siege was lifted and the front lines advanced, we went in and started construction of a 50-bed hospital, and also had plans to restart vaccination and set up a series of health posts in the rural villages that would refer people to that centralized hospital. We completed the construction of the hospital in June, and we had imported all of the medicine and the equipment for the hospital and had it pre-positioned to go into Syria. Unfortunately, the week before we were due to open the hospital, there was a major attack on Kobane, and the hospital was destroyed over the course of the weekend in the attack. So that basically put us back to square one in the course of a day. It was absolutely devastating. We had worked the last 4 months to build this very quickly. Losing everything in a weekend was devastating. We basically, at that point, needed to reevaluate completely what we were doing, and we decided to focus on opening a series of health clinics still. We brought in vaccines and started a routine immunization for children in the entire area for the first time in several years. And so basically we were able to import them from Europe and begin vaccinating children again, which was a major accomplishment for us. We also started a mental health program, which was essential because, I mean, you can see in a place like all over Syria, it's post-apocalyptic in some places. You see the video of places like Aleppo and Homs and Kobane, and you see total destruction of towns and villages and dust and cement, and it's horrible to see, let alone to live in. We really, really felt that providing the very basic health care for people, you know, to provide immunization, which is often the most relevant thing that you can do for a population in that situation, where if you can prevent something from happening, it's much better than treating it curatively afterwards. Also being relevant is being present and witnessing their situation and understanding what their life was like before the war and now what their life is like after the war. I mean, that's invaluable medicine. People, after 5 years of total war in their home country, they recognize that things aren't right, that you can give them some hope. You can listen to them, you can provide psychosocial activities. This is really important work that needs to be done.